was plunged in darkness, in a land surrounded by the extravagant Roman and promiscuous Persian empires, in an economically, politically, socially, militarily, ethically, and spiritually downtrodden Arabia, in an idol-worshipping, superstitious, ignorant, backward, barbaric, and misogynistic city, came a man, a light, who was set to change it all. A man who was sent as a mercy to mankind. A man who was to become the most influential human being to ever walk the face of this earth. Sir George Bernard Shaw named him a savior of humanity. Thomas Carlyle called him a silent great soul. Dr. William Draper pronounced that he exercised the greatest influence upon the human race. Reverend Bosworth Smith observed that he was the head of state as well as the church. He was Caesar and Pope in one. W. Montgomery Watt remarked that none of the great figures of history is so poorly appreciated in the West as him. Alphonse de Lamartine asked, who could dare to compare any great man in modern history with him? He was the best of all prophets, to whom came the best of all angels, with the best of all books, in the best of all languages, with a message for the whole of mankind of all times. His name was Muhammad. Peace be upon him.